Welcome to Train Signal. This is the Threat Management Gateway 2010 training course. This is an introductory course entitled Getting Started with Threat Management Gateway 2010 Training. In this lesson, I'm going to start by talking a little bit about what we're going to build in this course. Next, I'll talk a little bit about myself, followed by some more information about the course itself. Next up, some items you should understand before you begin this course, and then how to use this course to best effect. First of all, what are we building in this course? Well, we're going to be implementing Microsoft Threat Management Gateway 2010 for a company called GlobalMantix, and I'll explain more about GlobalMantix later on. But what you're going to learn is real business justification for implementing various aspects of the Threat Management Gateway 2010 product, including web access protection and server publishing rules. And you'll understand how to map your existing firewall skills to Threat Management Gateway 2010 concepts. If you already understand something about a firewall, just because you're going to a new product doesn't mean you have to throw away everything you know. In fact, it's actually better if you have some semblance of understanding of how a firewall works before you embark on your TMG 2010 training. You'll also learn how to best leverage Threat Management Gateway's malware protection features to keep GlobalMantix malware free. It used to be where just viruses were the scourge of the day in an organization. Today, there's any number of scourges classified as malware, viruses, spyware, what have you, that you want to keep off the machines in your organization. This whole classification is called malware, and you can use Threat Management Gateway's malware protection features to keep an organization as close to malware-free as is humanly possible. You'll also learn how to monitor Threat Management Gateway to make sure that it runs in peak operating condition. As an edge firewall, Threat Management Gateway has to stay available or your users won't be able to use the internet. Now a little bit about myself. As I mentioned, my name is Scott Lowe, and before you get confused, there are more than one of us out there in internet land. There's another Scott Lowe that happens to work for EMC, and he is a VMware guru and the author of a number of books about VMware. I am the Vice President and Chief Information Officer for Westminster College in Fulton, Missouri. I'm also a prolific author with more than 1,500 technical articles and my own range of books, mostly on Exchange and home networking, under my belt. Now, the articles are on a whole wide variety of topics that run the IT gamut, and they're written for such organizations as Tech Republic, VirtualizationAdmin.com, and TechTargets Search CIO Midmarket.com. I'm also a Microsoft Certified Systems Engineer, and I'm a frequent early adopter of new technologies with an emphasis on Microsoft products. With the exception of a significant VMware implementation at Westminster College, if you walk around the Westminster Data Center, you're going to see a whole lot of Microsoft, and I believe in Microsoft technologies, and I deploy them in my organization effectively, I hope. I'm also a seasoned IT professional with more than 16 years of experience. I started in the IT world in 1994 and came up through the ranks. I'm a father of two and a husband of one. My 7-year-old son is proficient with his iPod Touch and Internet Explorer, and my 6-year-old daughter has IE mastered, and you cannot imagine what she can do with an iPad. We're a very tech-oriented family. More importantly, about the course. You bought the course because you want to learn about Threat Management Gateway 2010, not about me. In this course, you're going to learn how to install the product. We figured that would be a really nice way to start and kind of gets you off the ground in a good way. You'll also learn how to create new firewall rules and make configuration changes to the HTTP protocol handling in Threat Management Gateway for additional levels of security. You'll also learn how you can inspect even protected SSL-secured HTTPS web traffic using Threat Management Gateway. Threat Management Gateway includes what's called URL filtering to help keep your users from visiting prohibited sites, either intentionally or accidentally. Further, you'll learn how to use the web caching and proxy services in Threat Management Gateway to help reduce the ongoing operating costs for GlobalMantix. Next up, you'll learn how to implement a web access policy that makes sense given GlobalMantix business needs, and you'll learn how to publish internal services, for example, websites, Exchange, VPNs, so that they're consumable from internet-based users. Now, there's a whole variety of internet-based users out there. Some happen to be the public, for example, GlobalMantix customers or partners. And some are GlobalMantix employees themselves who may work from home offices or maybe on the road as part of a mobile sales force and need remote access into the global Mantix environment. So there's all kinds of different users, and there's different use cases around how you'll use the different threat management gateway technologies to support these different classifications of users. But before you embark on your threat management gateway journey, there's some things you have to understand. First of all, you should have basic to intermediate server administration knowledge. The threat management gateway system runs on Windows Server 2008 R2, and you need to have an understanding for basic configuration techniques with that operating system. You should have a broad, not necessarily deep, but broad understanding of firewall technologies and options. You also need a broad knowledge of networking, including TCP/IP, and how routing and subnetting works in TCP/IP. Frankly, without that knowledge itself, now you could probably get by without the actual server knowledge if you really, really had to, but without the knowledge of networking to a point, you're going to be very lost with any firewall product, including Threat Management Gateway. However, if you do need help, you can expand your foundational knowledge with these train signal products: Group Policy, Active Directory, TCP/IP, and Networking Fundamentals. This course is intended to be used at your leisure. You can use it in any way, shape, or form that you like that works for you. But there are some different things that we want to make sure you're aware of to make sure that you can get the most out of this course. First of all, follow along at home and practice, practice, practice. Now, you're not going to get very far by simply watching this video and then walking into a production environment and hoping you remember it all. Your best bet is to follow along at home and practice, practice, practice. If you're planning to eventually take a forthcoming certification from Microsoft on Threat Management Gateway 2010, at present there is not one, this is your best possible certification preparation. Practice is always the best medicine. But if you're planning to use this in production, don't forego the practice, because you have to understand this stuff before you put it into a production environment. Make sure that you use the lab setup lesson to learn how to build your own complete lab environment. The environment that I've built here for you is very easy to follow along with. And I'm going to explain exactly how to set up the lab so that you can use all of the features that are available in Threat Management Gateway exactly as I have in this course. And lest you think you can't do this because you don't have the software, well, Microsoft makes 180-day trial software available for server buildouts. So you can play with this for 180 days at home and then go to work and deploy it. Make sure that you take notes along the way as well. Note the timestamp for particularly interesting topics so that you can come back later for additional review or something that's advanced or something you need to deploy in your own environment. You can generally watch the videos in any order you like, although I do recommend you watch the foundational videos if you don't have familiarity with installing and configuring the base product first. And if something doesn't quite go right or doesn't make sense, go back and try it again. And if you still don't quite get it, let us know in the Train Signal forums. We want to know, and we want to help you in your threat management gateway journey. And we are here to help.